Looking for a way to quickly and easily schedule appointments using Airtable? Forms are the perfect solution. Here's how you can use Airtable's forms to create a simple booking system. To start, you'll need to create or modify two new tables in a base of your choice. I'll use this CRM base as an example and create two new tables called Meeting Availability and Meeting Schedule. The first table will contain all of the details about my available meeting slots. In the primary field, I'll list out all of my available meeting times using the date field type. In your own base, feel free to add any other fields that may be useful to you, like the length of time you have available for each time slot or additional notes. The important thing to add is a linked record to the meeting schedule table. I'll call this field Scheduled Meeting. Now, I'll start filling in the table with all of my available meeting slots. Let's rename this view to All Time Slots, and then create a new grid view only for available meeting times. In this new view, we'll create a filter to hide all records that have information in the linked record field, so that only meeting times that have not yet been claimed will be visible. Now, let's navigate over to the meeting schedule table. This one will contain all of the details about the people who book meetings with you. I'll dedicate the primary field to their names. Again, feel free to add any other fields that are relevant for you here. I'll add in fields for the person's role, company, phone number, email, and notes. There's already a field linking to the meeting availability table, and for clarity, I'll rename this now to meeting time. Next, I'll create a new form in this table. All of the fields are already present in the form, but you can adjust the language in any way you like, so that they make the most sense to the viewer. The key change to make on this page is in the linked record field. Click on this field type and select the option to limit record selection to a view, and select the view that only contains the available time slots. Now, viewers will only be able to see and book time slots that haven't already been claimed. And once they pick a meeting slot and submit their form, their selected meeting time will disappear from the drop-down list. I'll show you how it works by filling out the form myself. I'll enter all of the necessary information, pick a time slot, and then submit the form. Now, if I navigate back to the meeting schedule table's grid view, I can see the new entry with a linked record listing its time slot. If I switch over to the meeting availability table, I can see the name listed next to its time slot in the view with all of the meeting times. But if I navigate to the filtered view, the meeting time has been filtered out and is not visible. Similarly, if I reopen the form, that meeting slot is no longer available from the drop-down list. Now that everything's up and running, send out the form's share link so that people can start booking time with you. And remember, keep updating your available meeting times so that the form always stays current. Now that you know the basics, try creating your own simple booking system. Of course, these principles will work for a multitude of use cases beyond booking meetings. You can also schedule classes, create an RSVP system for events, and much more. For even more information and inspiration, check out our blog post in the description below. And if you have any questions, thumb through our support articles, check out our community forum, or just write to us directly. Thanks for watching!